Freedom Daily News. Two welfare thugs forget they're in Texas and burglarize during hurricane evacuations, get brutal instant justice instead. Those in the Gulf Coast region of the United States have been bracing themselves for Hurricane Harvey for days now. The strength of winds puts Harvey as the strongest hurricane to make landfall on the Texas coast in upwards of 50 years. The last hurricane to make landfall in Texas as a Category 4 was Hurricane Carla, which made landfall on September 3, 1961 and left 43 direct fatalities in its wake. With an estimated property destruction of over $325 million, it was an impressive force of nature, and not one soon forgotten. Hurricane Harvey is expected to have roughly the same force, and the people of Texas aren't taking any chances. Evacuation, stockpiling and property securing began days ago, and Texas residents are ready to cope with whatever is left in Harvey's wake. While Texans are braced for an act of God, they're not looking to take the axe of vandals on the chin. The state of Texas is said to have an average of 7 firearms per household, and that doesn't change just because of the weather conditions. Apparently, there were some criminals looking to take advantage of this traumatizing situation and loot houses in the Gulf Coast region. This didn't turn out too well for them. The two incidents that have been reported thus far took place in Corpus Christi and the east side of Houston. Both burglars were looking to make a quick buck off of the natural disaster, but ran into their own disaster instead. Corpus Christi police had no new information Saturday about a man who was shot Friday by a homeowner after police say he broke into a Southside home. About 11 p.m., about an hour after Hurricane Harvey made landfall, police responded to the 7100 block of Ficus Court near Yorktown Boulevard, where they found a man who had been shot in the head. According to officers at the scene, the man broke into the residence and was shot by the homeowner. The man was taken to Christus Spahn Hospital Shoreline. As of 3 p.m. Saturday, police had no new information about the incident, said Senior Officer Travis Pace. The man's name and age also were unknown Saturday afternoon. No other major incidents were reported Friday night, he said. Since Hurricane Harvey's landfall, there have been some thefts. But Pace said he can't say for sure where each incident was reported. There also have been some traffic accidents, but no major accidents have been reported as of 3 p.m. Saturday, Pace said. Blue Lives Matter reported on that incident as well as a second that occurred in the east end of Houston. Two burglars shot in different burglaries during hurricane. Corpus Christi, Texas, two suspects were shot by homeowners in two separate incidents in Houston and Corpus Christi during Hurricane Harvey. In one incident, an intruder was shot by a Southside homeowner after he broke into the home as Hurricane Harvey made landfall. The incident occurred on Friday, August 25, about 11 p.m. in the 7100 block of Ficus Court, near Yorktown Boulevard, according to the Caller Times. Police officers responded to a home for a report of an intruder in the home. Upon their arrival, they found the suspect inside the home, with a gunshot wound to his head. Police said that the suspect had broken into the home, and the homeowner had shot him. The incident occurred about an hour after the Category 4 Hurricane Harvey made landfall near Corpus Christi. The suspect's name and the homeowner's name have not been released. It isn't known if the resident had power when the incident occurred. The suspect was transported to Christus Spahn Hospital Shoreline for treatment. His condition is not known. No other injuries were reported. The Corpus Christi Police Department is conducting the ongoing investigation. The second incident occurred in Houston about 3 a.m. in the 6900 block of Avenue T on Saturday, August 26. Police said that an intruder was trying to break into a home in Houston's Greater East End, and was shot by the homeowner, according to the Houston Chronicle. The intruder was reported to have been killed by the homeowner. No further information has been released, and the Houston Police Department is conducting the ongoing investigation. Burglars might want to think twice before they try to burglarize homes in a state where people are armed and willing to ride out the storm. While many residents were encouraged to flee the areas expected to take the brunt of the hurricane's force, many opted to stay in situations like this are part of the reason why. These are two of the incidents that we know of where the homeowners were home and willing to take matters into their own hands. We won't know until after the storm abates how many other homes with residents that weren't home were vandalized and taken advantage of. It's a sad day when we have to choose possible death by storm just to keep our positions from being looted. Hopefully, incidents like this will discourage others from taking advantage of a natural disaster, and keep personal property more safe the next time around. The residents of the Gulf Coast will have enough to deal with without having to cope with petty thieves.